All right. You two be quiet.
Okay.
All right. It's time to get ready to roll.
All right.
3, 2.
10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Injection, fellas.
Hello and welcome back to the studio. If you're new here, this is Totally 80s and 90s Recall, a podcast where we'll dive into everything the radical decades of the 1980s and 90s threw our way, from music and movies to television and pop culture. Hey, for our returning listeners slash subscribers, it is great to have you back. I am one of your hosts, David, joined as always by a guy who loves playing with the boys. It is, of course, my good friend, Rob.
I don't understand volleyball.
No?
I don't.
You're tall. No. Hit the ball. That's all you got to do. I gave you a rhyme, so you can't forget it.
I just took my glasses off.
Well, that's a good idea.
And I'm going to put them back on.
There you go. Well, what'd you take them off for?
I didn't think I needed them. All right. I got to read.
Your eyes don't work, so you definitely need them.
I'm getting old. Yep. Anyway. All right. Today's episode goes out to all of our international players.
Ooh.
Yeah. You know who you are. Here's what we know about you. You're laughing with another girl and playing with another heart. You're placing high stakes and making hearts ache.
Ooh, that's...
And you're loved in 7 languages. Dave and I have seen it 100 times. Diamond nights, ruby lights high in the sky. Heaven help you when you fall from the diamond life, lover boy. You move in space with minimum waste and maximum joy. Then there's the city lights and business nights when you require streetcar desire for higher heights. Am I right? In your world, there is no place for beginners or sensitive hearts when sentiment is left to chance. There's no place to be ending, but there's always somewhere to start. It's profound. Let's cut the bull. There's no need to ask. We all know who you are. Coast to coast, L.A. to Chicago, across the north and south, all the way to Key Largo, for crying out loud, your love is for sale. Face to face, each one is a classic case. You shadow box and you double cross. Yet you need the chase. You have a license to love, but you have an insurance to hold. I don't even know if I'm jealous or mad.
You are.
Now, if you walk away from today's episode hearing nothing, at least know this. You listen here, sir. You may be able to melt all your memories and change them into gold. And sure, your eyes might be like an angel's. But the 80s and 90s recall team knows that your heart is cold. There's no need to ask. The jig is up. We all know you're a smooth operator.
Ooh. Did you write that?
Nope.
Oh, okay. That was quick.
That's pretty good, huh?
I didn't write that at all.
Nope.
You could have taken credit for it.
Nope, I don't.
Is that from a band? I think it is a band.
Yeah. I'm not answering.
Yeah. Oh, you're so elusive.
So mysterious.
He is. Mm-hmm. Speaking of mysterious, we have a mysterious voice coming in from somewhere out way on the other side of the studio. It is the movie hound.
What?
Wow.
Why?
Why? Kurt is out of back. His element. And for the first time ever, he's here on a non-movie episode.
Yeah, how's that?
We have talked him into it.
And
he's here
like
today.
It.
And hey, no, you're supposed to say something positive. So,
okay,
go ahead.
I positively don't like it.
So welcome back.
Well, welcome thank back. You for having me or forcing me to come in today.
No one forced you to do anything.
I'm just saying. I am going to preface right now. I am not a music boy.
I'm going to tell you this might appease some fans. I got a couple messages that are like, hey, we like when Kurt's in the studio. Maybe you should bring him on for a music thing once in a while.
And so you chose an episode of music when I'm 6 years old.
Well, Rob and I were 10 years old. Yeah. So it doesn't matter.
I was 9.
Like, but we've been around since then. So
I'm just saying, I got a lot of built-in excuses for my poor choices that will be happening.
Okay. Maybe they're not poor. Someone's going to side with you today.
Maybe.
I promise.
As somebody that usually makes poor choices, I will tell you, there's somebody that will get, that, somebody, they'll side with you. Somebody out there will go, Kurt's list is great.
Those were
it's the best list.
Those
I want to meet those people and tell them I'm sorry.
They say those are the ones I would have chosen. So, well, we're all here.
Yeah.
The hound is squatted in his corner.
Yeah.
I have
squatted. We're here.
Yeah.
So, why don't we share with the fans, since he kind of alluded mm-hmm. that it's going to be musical,
yeah.
what we're doing for this week's episode.
We are doing a 1986 movie music.
Whoa.
See, you're in the...
Oh, my goodness. You've got him all yeah. discombobulated. We're doing a
1986 music draft.
Music draft.
With all sorts of stupid rules.
There's not stupid rules, Rob.
You and your stupid
rules. That we all are, read ahead of time.
I know.
There are just some guidelines to keep us on track so that we don't run around like chickens with our heads cut off.
Mm. Well, I don't run at all.
Right?
Huh? I don't run at all. So.
I mean, you could.
You didn't tell us I'd be running.
I've seen both of you run. We've run together, Rob.
And
you've run a marathon.
And I never did a marathon.
Oh, you've done a half marathon.
He did. Yes. He did multiple halves. So therefore, you've done a whole.
That's
and
true.
Add them
you've done like a trail run or something too, right?
Yeah, 20. I drove 26 miles. That's a long way.
Oh yeah, same. That's same.
I'm not running 26 miles.
Okay, but you've run. 13.
I did 13.1.
Yeah. But you did it twice.
And I got lapped by a lady speedwalking.
It doesn't matter. She did not speedwalking.
She was.
Then she wasn't speedwalking. She was doing something else.
Speedwalking.
I don't believe it.
She was walking really fast.
All right. Okay. Well, 1986. We're talking about music.
Yeah.
Rob's on board with that now.
All right. Yeah, I'm here. I'm good.
You said movies at first.
I know.
All right.
I wished it were movies.
Yeah. And he says he wished it was movies. We've already done 86 movies before. So this is 86 music. Big year for music. How did you like looking at these selections? We'll talk about our guidelines later, but just looking at the selections you had to go through, some good music this year, yeah?
There was some okay music.
Yeah, okay.
I knew some of the songs.
Okay, that's nice.
Some of them I had to push play on.
Sorry, 80s aficionado over here.
I told you, don't get your hopes up on this guy.
All right.
I kind of feel similar. I felt like there was a really key core group of songs to pull from. And I'm fearful that we're all going to try and go for the same. So I had to dig deep into some.
Oh, not the deep digging.
I had to have some ready because there's some that are just staples of 86. You hear them and you go, that's an 86.
Well, 86 we've
classic
got.
Classic 80s song.
Yeah, you said there's a core group. But 86, you got huge pop hits. Berlin, mm-hmm. Madonna, mm-hmm. Whitney Houston. Mm-hmm. Right, arena rock groups like U2, Bon Jovi.
Okay, that is something that I did notice.
What's that?
Is the eclectic range of styles.
Yes.
Because you had synth stuff happening. Yep. You still had some kind of jingly rock stuff. Yep. You had some hard rock stuff.
That's why I chose it. 86 is good.
You had some R&B in there. So there was a pretty wide range of stuff.
Mm-hmm. Great like
styles.
A great plethora. We had some mainstream.
You like that word.
Plethora. Yeah, it's a good word.
Do you know what a plethora is?
Do you?
I do.
What is it? It
means a lot.
Oh. All this time I thought plethora was when all the continents were together.
That's right.
Oh, no, that's
Pangea. That's Pangea.
That's Pangea.
That's Pangea. Yeah.
Rob had to channel his teaching stuff right there.
That's right.
Pangea.
Yeah. So, all right, yeah.
Anyway.
But I think lots to go from. Yet hip-hop and R&B is, I would say, starting to emerge more. Because in the early 80s, not as much unless you're listening to specific radio stations, charts. Mm-hmm. MTV wasn't playing a lot of the mm-hmm. R&B hip-hop stuff. So a lot of more rock-oriented. Mm-hmm. And then if they got into the pop stuff with the British pop invasion.
The British.
Some of that synth you were talking about, Rob.
The British.
Yes. So, but overall, I think it's a good selection of music.
Yeah.
Big albums. Beastie Boys had their first big album come out. Yeah. Janet Jackson's first big album came out. What was the name of that album, Rob?
Not Control.
No, I don't.
No, I don't think so.
What's the name of the album? Control is one of the songs on the album.
I don't know.
Oh. Don't leave the fans at home hanging. Like, give them some information here. You know, I promise we prep for the show, folks.
Some of us.
That's
not
good.
Me.
Why is he making that noise?
I believe it was self-titled.
Self-titled.
Yeah. Okay. No, actually, her first album came out in 82.
Oh, okay. And that was self-titled.
And it was called Janet Jackson.
Okay. Yeah. So what's the one in 86 called?
84.
Oh.
There was Dream Street.
Okay. So that's two.
Yeah. People didn't want it. People don't want to hear
Let's say this is her first big album. So 86. Because this has Control and Nasty Boys.
I think
and all
it's
that
Control.
Stuff. Oh, okay. He's going back on that. He's falling back to that.
No. 86, Control.
Hey, he did it, folks.
Dang it.
I knew it was that the whole time. I just want to make you question yourself.
Question myself.
That's right.
You're an ass.
You should have stood firm. You had no reason not to stand firm.
I'm sorry.
Be like, no, that's what it is.
This means my thinking was fragile.
Okay.
If I was confident in it, I would have just owned
it. Gone right
I would have argued with you, but I didn't.
All right. Well, as I said, I was 10 years old. Rob's about a 9-ish. You said you were 6.
I'm a 6er.
Because you were an 80 baby.
79.
Okay. Mm-hmm. How late?
October.
Ooh.
I just pulled into the 70s.
So you're a Halloween kid. So
I'm pretty freaky.
Well, even though we were young, lots of notable things happening in 1986. I'm going to start with the bad.
Oh, boy.
I was in school when this happened. We were watching on TV.
Oh, I know what you're going to say.
The Challenger shuttle, unfortunately, did not go well.
I was in Mrs. Williams' second grade class.
I was in
Did she make you tea?
What?
Mrs. Williams.
She made me tea.
Made love to me.
Turned on the tele.
What is that?
The BBC.
BBC.
Sorry. One. I had to go back to movies.
Yeah, awesome power. He can't
awesome
help
powers.
Himself. Cannot. Right? I was in fourth grade. Mrs. Biasted was her name.
Wow.
Yeah, that was it.
First, I was in Mrs. Fourth. Davis's kindergarten class.
Was she Southern?
She was.
Why are you talking like that? You're from Washington State. No one was talking like
Sometimes
that.
Sometimes accents in
there. I'm Miss Davis. You didn't. You weren't going.
I went Billy Bob.
You weren't
for a
in West Canaan. Horror movies.
More movies.
More Louisiana.
Let's focus. Okay.
Focus on music.
Another. Focus. Another. another bad. The Chernobyl situation. A little meltdown they had over there in on the other side of the world. So, but let's go to the good. Some good stuff happened in 1986. Statue of Liberty reopened after a long repair / refurbishing period.
After that whole Ghostbusters debacle.
That's right.
In 84. Yeah. No, that was in 89. This is 86.
Oh, yeah.
You're fine. They didn't use it until Ghostbusters 2.
That's cool.
They should have patted her feet when they remodeled her.
I know.
More movies. Okay.
you brought up Ghostbusters.
for the first time in 75 years, Haley's Comet came flying around. I don't know. Did you watch it?
I don't know.
I remember my dad.
Were you out there with your...
I remember my dad saying we should go out and we had a telescope.
I don't know.
I don't remember seeing it, but he said that it was going to happen.
Past my bedtime.
All right. And Ronald Reagan signed a bill making MLK Day an official holiday.
Oh, yeah.
Sounds good. So 1986. Yeah. Probably took a little longer than it should have, but that's fine.
Yeah. I guess I didn't realize that was as recent as it was. I thought that would have been around for a long time.
I would have thought so too, but
no,
it is what it is. All right. On TV, Rob.
Oh, boy.
Top shows. Cosby Show.
No. Ooh. Great show.
Family Ties.
Mm.
Cheers. Murder, She Wrote.
Ooh. Yaga.
I like Angela Lansbury, don't we? She's solving crimes.
That's right.
Baking pies.
I was watching
that a few weeks ago.
And Gold. Hey,
I was.
Where are you?
This one you're going to like. The Golden Girls.
Ooh, I like The Golden
Girls. Do you like The Golden Girls? It's a funny show. Movies. Top five at the box office. Got any guesses in 1986? Since you want to talk movies so much.
Was it Ghostbusters in there?
No, that's 84, Rob. 84. Come on, man. Okay, I'm going to give you the first one.
Top Gun.
Top Gun was number one. Number two, Crocodile Dundee.
Not a knife.
That's not a knife. Number three, Platoon.
Oh, I like that.
Good one. Number four, Karate Kid Part Deux.
Part Deux.
Yes.
And when he goes overseas.
Goes overseas.
Yeah, that's right.
Goes to Okinawa.
Okinawa.
Filmed in Hawaii.
Oh, yeah.
Did you do the Triple Lindy on the back to school?
Oh, I did.
Number six.
It was number six. I only took top five. but the fifth was Star Trek IV, The Voyage Home.
Wait, what was number six?
Back to school.
Right. Oh, back
to school. He hasn't seen it.
Haven't seen it.
David, you know what number eight is?
I only went to the top five.
The Golden Child.
All right.
Oh, and you love that movie. You don't like that movie.
It's rough. Even for Eddie Murphy, it's not my favorite.
But he likes it.
I know. It's weird.
And he's got good taste in movies.
Not so much.
I don't know if we're going to say that. So, all right. But yeah, Star Trek IV Voyage Home. Did you watch that one? It's where they had to go back in time to get a whale.
Yes, the whales.
No,
whales. I remember the whales.
Had to go get the whales. All right. So, in sports, Rob, the New York Mets came back in Game 7 to beat the Red Sox World Series. Famous Buckner.
Through the
Legs World Series.
Poor
Billy Buckner. The Bears won the Super Bowl. Remember that team?
15-1. Oh, was that the Super Bowl shuffle?
Yeah, the fridge is scoring touchdowns.
That's right.
Walter Payton is not.
Walter Payton? Nope. They gave it to the fridge instead.
McMahon.
Dicka did not like the Payton.
Dicka.
The Bears. A mix of Baker's dozen, Bob.
And the Celtics, Rob likes this, won the NBA championship led by
Larry Bird.
Larry Bird. And who else, Rob?
Kevin McHale.
Kevin McHale and?
The Chief.
Who else was on that team?
Danny Ainge.
He might have been on that team. Dennis Johnson.
Oh, yeah.
What about the Chief?
I like the Chief.
Robert Parrish. Yeah, there you go. Yeah, so they had that. That was the squad.
Do you think they'd make it today?
No.
No.
Not under the rules.
The Chief
but not under again? Now rules.
Not the rules they have now, because they were allowed to be a lot more physical.
Oh, that's true.
When the Chief and McHale can throw elbows and there's no penalties.
Right, then we're good.
We're fine. But as soon as you got now, if you sneeze on someone, it's a foul.
That's true.
McHale wouldn't make it out of the first quarter.
That's true.
So, and I don't know if you go back and watch some of his skills. I think some of the people he play against nowadays are a little more athletic. I'm not questioning him. He played a long time in the NBA. But I just think from a speed and jumping standpoint, he may be at a little disadvantage.
I don't know.
You imagine him up against Joel Embiid or some of those guys? Might be tough, right? So, you never know. Actually, Embiid's hurt all the time, so it doesn't matter. All right,
it doesn't.
I got some miscellaneous for you, Rob. First class of musicians was inducted into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame.
In 86?
86.
Wow.
All right, the list, Rob. Buddy Holly.
Ooh.
Chuck Berry.
Okay.
Elvis.
Yeah.
Fats Domino.
Wow.
James Brown, hardest working man in show business.
Okay.
Jerry Lee Lewis.
Hey.
Everyone's favorite.
The killer.
Guy
the killer.
That,
I think they call him the killer.
A cousin or something, right?
He married his cousin.
He married a third cousin, yeah.
Ray Charles.
Oh.
Which, after watching that movie, had a little bit of a drug problem. Yeah. Kind of probably made Nikki Sixx look like a casual user compared to Ray Charles. So
I've mentioned it. There's a podcast called Cocaine and Rhinestone.
Oh yeah, I need to check
that
out.
It's about country music the 70s and stuff.
It's tough.
And
Waylon Jennings.
Some of those.
The
whole Judd debacle. The Judd family's a mess.
Yeah,
talk about.
We've done our Judd time on here. Ooh. Hey, mama. All right. Couple more. Anyway. Sam Cooke. The Everly Brothers.
Ooh.
So the induction took place in New York City, actually, because the museum in Cleveland was not. Built till 9 years later. So they just had it kind of in a casual Marriott or something. I don't know. Maybe the Plaza Hotel.
At the ballroom.
At the ballroom, yes.
A conference center.
Yeah. It's like a midday thing at the Best Western.
That's right. Yeah. Break out your finest.
No, break out your finest what?
I don't know. Whatever they have. China?
Something that's fine.
I don't think the Best Western has any China.
They might.
You know. That's usually where that's usually where you go for like those they do the conference room, be like a real estate Ponzi scheme. You'll get rich if you do this. Right? So that's where they did the first rock and roll induction. Conference.
That's right.
Or a teaching conference.
We've done several. Right.
Yeah. So and you've learned a lot. You got a sticker to prove it.
Still here.
Working it. So all right, you guys got anything else to add about 1986?
No, it was a year.
It was a year.
It was the middle of the 80s.
That's right.
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, it's kind of like.
Do you have any good memories? Anything, Rob?
I was nine.
The whole point of this show is to like entertain people. So do you have anything that you'd like to share with somebody?
Second grade.
Story. Second grade. Tell us about second grade, Rob.
Mrs. Williams.
Okay.
Yeah. She was really nice to me. Yeah,
she was really nice. Are we on our loop? Oh, my God.
They love to me.
No, Mrs. Williams.
You know, if he was in second grade and Mrs. Williams was making him tea, it might be Mary Kay Letourneau. This might be happening. No. So.
She did tell me I was her favorite student.
I bet she did.
Years later.
Oh, years.
Yeah, when I was an adult.
Oh.
Yeah.
You ran back into her.
I did.
Then she made you tea.
No.
I'll take a gray, miss.
I don't like tea.
Yeah, he wanted a good stiff drink.
I want Earl Grey, miss.
Earl Grey.
Anything you can remember from 1986?
86. Ooh. That was the year I started playing soccer.
Oh, I like it.
Yes.
6 years old. You can remember that?
I do.
Nice.
Played on little goals.
Little goals.
Little baby goals.
Little baby goals. Yeah. Were you scoring on the little baby goals?
No, I was always defense.
Oh, yeah.
Hated the offense. I don't know why.
So weird. You know Howard the Duck came out in 1986. Well, did you enjoy that?
I probably did a few years later.
Yeah, okay. From our 86 movie selections, Rob also noted that Iron Eagle, I believe, came out.
Ooh.
In 1986.
The knockoff.
R.I.P. Chappie.
Yeah.
It actually, I think we had that discussion. It came out before, Top Gun. But Top Gun was just better.
They might have rushed it. I don't know.
Yeah, I think they ran it out because they were worried Top Gun was going to be good. And it was. Because their story was really dumb.
Did you know Lady Gaga was born in 86?
Ooh, good one. Yeah. I always found some historical facts.
Yeah, there's some. Anybody Lindsay else? Lohan.
Was she born?
Shia LaBeouf.
Shia.
Was born in 86?
Was she born Lady Gaga?
I believe so.
Little Baby Gaga.
Was that her baby name?
She just came out of the womb like that.
She said Gaga.
She said Gaga. And they said, oh, that'll fit.
He's so clever. He wrote that down, folks.
I did.
In his notes, when can I use this joke?
I have a little stack of note cards with jokes on
it. You think she just came out? Only my poker face.
What is wrong with you? Nothing's wrong with me.
Yeah. What is wrong with you? All right. I think we've exhausted everything we could talk about in 1986 because your two's memories are just fuzzed up.
I don't know.
Full multiple repair.
It's been a long day.
All right. Well, let's flip on the dial of our radio over and find our favorite songs as we rewind the clock to dance and party back in 1986. Still see Rob as an adult. Do you have cubby wubby room room tea?
I like a good sweet tea.
I bet you do.
Sweet tea.
Oh, is she making sweet tea? Mrs. Williams.
Making sweet love to me, mother.
All right. Well, for this week, as we've mentioned, we're going to have a little fun picking out our music instead of just grabbing whatever you feel like. It's our second ever musical draft. That's right. Our second ever, Rob. Musical what?
Draft.
The fans are excited.
Wow, they are excited.
They're pumped up. Yeah. They know it's going to be a good day. We did this previously with our 1987 number one hits. It was just you and me. So
just me and you.
We just went back and forth. But we've added our third today. The Movie Hound is in the studio to test his musical prowess.
It's going to be failing.
It's going to be fine.
With an emphasis on test.
I have a lot of faith in you. I think I'm going to be excited about your songs. Well, all the draft members have access to the entire year of 1986. There are, however, as Rob mentioned in the beginning, a few rules.
Stupid rule.
Or what I like to call guidelines that we're going to follow. And we'll just run through this real quick. That way everybody's on board. Everybody feels like it's on a level playing field. So when I defeat you too soundly, you can't complain about it.
Okay.
All right?
That's correct.
Let's see. All the songs selected must have been released in 1986 as a single or be on the year-end Billboard Hot 100 for all of 1986. So technically, if a song was released in late 85, but still charted in 86 and made the Billboard final year 100, that song is eligible.
Okay.
Also, if the album was released in 85, but a song was not released as an official single until 86, also available to draft. Do you see what he's doing?
That's right.
It's annoying. Yeah, Kip, shut off his microphone. That's what I'm telling you. All right. Turn him off until he can behave. Once an artist or group is chosen, that artist or group is off limits to everybody else in the draft. So, as an example, Rob, give us an example.
If you picked, I don't know,
Lionel Richie,
Anita Baker.
Okay.
Yeah, and then.
No one else can draft anything from Anita Baker. She's off the board.
Off the board.
Beautiful. If a band member or solo artist is chosen as part of a duet, they are off limits to everyone else as a solo artist. However, if they're back with their actual band, you can still select songs from the band.
Okay.
All right. So no solo songs.
So example would be
Phil Collins, slash Genesis.
So if you picked him as Phil Collins.
Correct.
He's off.
But he could still be Genesis.
Okay. All right.
Once both are picked, both gone.
Okay.
All right. Finally, we have categories so that we can draft our songs into, or we're not just picking willy-nilly. Otherwise, Rob would come up with some concoction. The Robsters would be excited, but everybody else would be like, okay. You can draft any category in any turn. All right. You just have to fill all six categories because that's how many we have. And here are our categories. Your favorite new wave slash synth pop song.
Got it.
Favorite number one song of the year. Any song that hit number one on the Billboard Hot 100 during the year.
Okay.
I believe there were 31 number one hits. Mm-hmm. So you had plenty to choose from. Your favorite pop song by a male or female solo artist. Okay. Your favorite pop song by a group or duet.
Mm.
Your favorite rock song by a band. Band consisting of two or more members.
Okay.
All right. And the final category is wild card. That is a song from 1986 in any genre that you choose. Has to be from 1986.
Okay.
So, or it could be on the year-end chart like we discussed earlier.
Okay.
Well, before the show, we scientifically chose our draft order.
Yes.
Out of a bowl.
Yeah.
Your wife chose for us.
Three.
She was very, very thorough.
Yeah, very. Three sticky notes.
Yes. I'm not happy with how it went. But this is how it went. So the movie hound, Kurt, somehow pulled the number one pick.
Yeah.
I pull.
What the guy that doesn't know what he's doing pulled the number one pick. So I'm going to go in the dreaded two spot, which leaves Rob on the rear as the number three.
On the rear.
Right? So you're taking the third spot.
Coming in from behind.
And we're going to snake the draft. So if you have the first or third selection, so between you two, when it's your turn, you'll get two selections. Except for the very first pick, and the very last pick. He only gets one, you only get one. So with that, do we understand all the guidelines?
Yeah, I kind of started phasing out.
If we mess it up, I'm sure you'll tell us.
I will. Okay. I have a buzzer. I don't have a buzzer. I wish I had a buzzer, but if you screw something up, I'll just go.
Time out.
There you go. That tells you you've made a mistake.
That's right.
You've drafted more than one category.
It's not like we're going to fix it.
No, we will fix it.
All right? I'm not fixing this.
That's the way it's going to go. So... anything else before we get started?
Yeah. Are we excited? No, I think we're good.
I don't really like your attitude. I want a little more excitement in this. All right, let's pick up the pace here a little bit.
Pick it up, a little perky pace.
Well, all right, we're ready to go. As Rob said, he's ready to go. The first pick has gone over to our movie hound Kurt. So Rob,
yeah, we're
ready
good.
To hear what Kurt. Wants to pick.
Okay.
So on the clock with the first pick.
All right.
All righty. So my first pick, I'm going to go with the category favorite male-female group duet
song. Like it.
And I went with, I'm going to go with the Run DMC and Aerosmith.
Oh.
With the A Walk This Way.
Mm-hmm, that's a good one. We found them.
I found them. They're walking in.
Yeah, they had to break through the wall.
That's right.
Really good pick. This was on one of my lists.
Very timely, considering.
So you have taken away a song that I would have considered choosing.
Yeah, a choosable song. Well, at least I chose one choosable song.
So I'm not happy. I'm not super happy that you stole that.
I'm sorry. But I put that it introduced this suburban six-year-old white kid to some rap and some rock. So
you didn't know about the rock before?
Well, I was six. I was listening to
I think
Snoopy
you're right,
tapes.
Though. I think because in 86, Aerosmith was more of like a classic.
They were still a
70s band. Yeah. And this was kind of a rebirth for them.
Yeah. So that was big in their 70s stuff when I was six. Big. I was just waiting for them to come back. No,
I saw, he's like, when are they going to drop a new album?
That's right.
So
it was 3 months in the 70s I was alive. Jeez, I loved them.
I've been just waiting so long.
But it's one song, and as I was going through the list, I was like, I remember the song.
I remember
it. It was impactful. Nice. I actually remember the video of the crashing through the wall.
Oh, yeah.
The Run DMC with the sneakers and the hats.
Well, I saw an interview. Rick Rubin, the producer, said that this is, like you had just said, across the United States, this pretty much put them into suburbia. Mm-hmm. So it expanded their reach.
That's right.
And this became MTV friendly because it had rock combined with it. So because it was played all the time. Because before then, MTV was a little known in the early 80s not to be as kind to playing black artists as they played rock and roll. Mm-hmm. So this gave an opportunity for them to see how popular that would be.
Yeah.
I also read, because I had looked at this song, I also read that Run DMC didn't want to collaborate with Aerosmith.
Yeah.
Originally, they'd asked Aerosmith, they just wanted to use the beat, and then they wanted to rap over the beat. But Rick Rubin stepped in and goes, no, let's combine this. And then they did, and I think Rick Rubin probably made the right choice, right? It's like he knows what he was doing, right, Rob?
Yes.
You think so?
Yeah, he was.
You were in deep thought there for a second.
Sorry.
I thought he was falling asleep. I don't know what's going on.
Gone.
I was looking at my list, folks.
He is not impressed with your first pick.
I'm sorry. I'll try to make my next choices better.
No, that's a really good one.
They're probably going to get worse from
here. No, I think that's a really good pick. That's a great pick.
Okay, well, I have the second pick.
You do have the second pick.
And we're only going to do this for the first round because we don't want to annoy the whole world.
Well,
That's
to assume that we haven't already annoyed.
I know.
The people are like,
but we've
done a lot of yapping.
We've yapped a lot so far. Too much yapping. I can see on here we've done 31 minutes of yapping.
Yes.
So that's fine. Yes. So I'm going to, in my first pick, second pick of the draft, I'm going to go in the new wave category because I feel like this has less stuff in it than some of the other categories. And I am going to take basically what was my number one song for all of 86. Maybe. I pushed play, but it didn't work. Think the internet died on me?
Could have.
Well, the song that I'm going to play was going to be West End Girls by the Pet Shop Boys. And unfortunately, I'm having a little technical difficulty.
Just sing it.
In a Western town of Denver, East End Boys, Western Girls. You know, everybody hates this, right?
Is it not there?
We're gonna nope, edit
we're
this
good.
Out.
We could edit it later.
A few moments later.
Just that one song? Alright, start over.
I did sing a little of this.
Yeah, it was good.
You're an ass.
Who's an ass? How am I the ass?
Because
it wasn't working. Not my fault.
But you stole my song.
I had this one on my list as well.
Great. So, like I said, this is probably my favorite song of 1986. This is by the Pet Shop Boys. Did a little bit of research on it. I just picked the song one because I think it's the coolest song in 1986.
And what category was that?
New Wave.
Oh, you did New Wave.
Got it in New Wave. To me, this is one of the coolest songs in all of 1986. I remember listening to this even as a 10-year-old all the time. I thought it was super awesome. Let's see. The West End refers to the club scene in London, which is where all the action and the ladies were. Unlike the much rougher East End of London. Foggy London town. Fun fact. Sting on a BBC interview, Rob, stated West End Girls is his third favorite recording of all time.
Wow, that was two and one.
Outside of this song at number three, I'm not sure the order, but here's the other nine. Number Sitting on the Dock of the Bay, Otis Redding. Okay. No Woman, No Cry, Bob Marley.
Good song.
Baker Street, awesome song by Jerry Rafferty. Careless Whisper, George Michael. Here Comes the Rain Again, The Eurythmics. Don't You Want Me, The Human League. Sledgehammer by Peter Gabriel. It Wasn't Me by Shaggy. Good one. One I'd never heard of, A Whiter Shade of Pale by Procol Harum. I just never heard of that one, so. Song was named Song of the Decade from 85 to 94 by the British Academy of Composers and Songwriters. Very popular song.
Wow. There it is.
Oh, it sounds so good.
That is a good song.
Oh, it's fantastic.
I'm really not happy with you right now.
Really not.
That was going to be my first pick.
I know. That's why it wasn't working. You set it up so that it wouldn't
work. I did. Sabotage. I'm a saboteur.
He couldn't stand it. I knew you planned it.
A saboteur.
I'm a saboteur.
All right, Rob. That means you get two picks. So Kurt chose in the duet group pop category.
All right, I chose
New Wave.
Okay.
So at number three.
Ooh.
Golly.
There's too much thinking here. I'm going to go down to a group duo. Group duo, wasn't it?
Stupid category. For pop music.
Stupid categories.
It's both. It's group
or duo. Are you doing group pop?
I'm doing group pop.
Okay.
Yes.
Nice.
Okay. And my song is.
Oh.
I love that song.
Sade.
Sade.
I do.
Rob loves Sade.
I do.
Man, listening to this podcast, I've learned Rob loves Sade.
I do. Sade.
There's a silent H.
Yeah. And her last name's Adu.
Are you saying Adu? Are you saying pan or pan?
No, okay. So this Sade.
Yes.
Did you know?
I did.
Sade was instantly popular and ushered in the smooth style that helped define the 80s. It was often known as Sophista Pop. I didn't know that. Yeah. The band achieved an impressive accomplishment on the charts as each one of their albums, including their live albums and compilation albums, made it to the coveted top 10 on the Billboard charts, with two of them going to number one. This is The Sweetest Taboo by the English band Sade, lead singer Sade Adu, from their second studio album Promise. It was released in October of 85. But charted, obviously, in 86. It reached number 5 on the Billboard Hot 100, and it remained on the top 40 for 13 weeks. She sings proudly and boldly about how she is given love, which brings out the best in her. Ooh. The Quiet Storm vibe allows one to stand and groove, dance to the soulful peace sound of the song. Her backing band, it's called Sweetback.
Sweetback.
Yeah. Sweet. And they formed in 94, but they kind of broke away and started their own little band.
I thought Sade was just a band itself.
Yeah, they are.
Oh, okay. But you said it's a backing band.
Well, her backing band in 94 went kind of solo? I don't know.
Solo.
Yeah, they went solo, but they were back.
Yeah.
They decided to go solo.
Anyway, okay. So that's that.
So that means we go to the top of the second round for the fourth pick. So your second straight pick.
Man.
So which category are we going to here?
Okay. I'm gonna go back to number ones.
Oh, number one.
Yeah. I'm going to my number one. Oh.
I'm still hearing Sade.
No, that's okay. Yeah,
is that your number one?
No. Just love Sade. No.
All day Sade.
So many choices.
I know it's tough. Did you not rack and stack them?
No.
Were you not prepared?
You screwed me up with the stupid...
Oh, here we go.
With the stupid pet shop boys.
It's all my fault.
All right. Here we go. This is my number two.
Two. Ah, Simply Red.
I love this song.
Really? This is a fantastic song.
I love this song. Such a good song.
You don't have to defend this. It's a great song. Got that voice.
So sultry.
Oh, yeah. We're going to talk about that voice.
Started out with a couple of love songs today, Rob.
Yeah.
Feeling a certain way.
Feeling saucy.
Are you? Oh, your anniversary is coming up. Maybe.
Ooh.
Maybe that's why.
Yeah, I got to start working out.
It's a little late.
Mm-hmm. It's never too late.
Yeah, so this is Simply Red, Holding Back the Years.
Real quick, Rob's got to do some working out, he said. So all you Robsters out there, send him some workout plans. He needs a good hit routine.
That's right.
He needs some kind of cardio to get get himself in fighting shape.
A little Tai Bo.
Fighting shape, is that what the anniversary is?
Yeah, that's what it is. And then once you're in fighting shape, you walk in the room. There it is.
That's right.
Yeah. Just tell her, keep holding on.
All my kids are at the movies tonight.
So. Oh. gonna get a little fun early.
It'll be past our bedtime.
Oh, my goodness.
So this is Holding Back the Years. British soul and pop band Simply Red released as the third single from their debut studio album. It reached number one, obviously. It's the category. The song was nominated in the category of Best Pop Performance by a Duo Group with Vocals for the 29th Annual Grammy Awards. They were up against The Next Time I Fall in Love, Peter Cetera and Amy Grant. On My Own, Michael McDonald and Patti LaBelle.
Ooh.
All I Need is a Miracle, Mike and the Mechanics. And That's What Friends Are For, Dionne Warwick, Elton John, Gladys Knight, and Stevie Wonder. And that whole foursome won there.
The Warwick gaggle?
Yeah, they won.
You'd like that song?
I love this. Oh, no, I don't. I don't like it. This song should have won. They only won that because of the people in it. Gee whiz.
No, have you listened to that song?
Yes, I've heard it.
That's what friends.
I know the song.
The three of us should sing that song. That's great.
One of my choices. You don't know.
Keep smiling.
Anyway, did you know the lead singer Mick Hucknall was so successful at wooing the ladies that he had to issue an apology to the quote thousands of women unquote he slept with? In an interview with Guardian, he estimated that he slept with 3,000 women in the space of 3 years. Quote, when I had the fame, it went crazy. Between 85 and 87, I would sleep with about 3 women a day, every day. I never said no. This was what I wanted from being a pop star. I was living the dream, and my only regret is that I hurt some really good girls. So
that's pre-Viagra years. That guy's a stallion.
That 3,000, three a day.
Well, he's drinking a lot of Gatorade or some kind of fluids to replenish bananas.
Three a day.
Some kind of
definitely needs
vitamin B or something. That's a lot of work. That feels like a lot of work.
Yeah.
Doesn't that feel like a lot of work? I think that feels like a lot of work.
Like too much work.
So.
Listen to that. That's a lot of work.
Three times a day seems exhausting. That does not.
Not seem good.
All right. That means it's time for my second pick, the fifth pick overall. Looking at these categories. I got to stay a step ahead of Rob here. I'm going to go with pop solo artist. And I'm going to look at, I've got quite a list of things here, but I think there's one in particular that sticks out like a sore thumb. And we've had him on the show before. He's fantastic. He's one of the best of the 80s. And it is the Beast.
Oh, I knew he was coming in here.
This could have also been eligible in the number one categories. This is the number one song. Oh, this is making you feel good, Rob.
No.
Sure.
I'm not a Steve Winwood fan. I don't know. They all sound the same.
You're the only one. You are incorrect. That's probably one of the worst things you've ever said on this podcast.
Oh, no.
I said way worse. No. That is Higher Love by Steve Winwood, a.k.a. on this show, The Beast. All right. So, and he's back. This is Winwood's first number one hit. He's got Chaka Khan singing on the track with him.
Chaka Khan. That's
Chaka
right.
Chaka Khan. I knew you
Chaka too. Khan.
How many times are we going to do that in a row? All right. So, gives it a bit of a gospel feel, Rob. I know how you feel about
look
that.
Look at you bringing it back to church.
Let's see. Won two Grammys, beating out Peter Gabriel and Robert Palmer.
What church did you go to that sounds like Steve Winwood?
To beat. I went.
To worship.
You know, that same one Forrest Gump went to.
You didn't know.
But yeah, he beat out Peter Gabriel and Robert Palmer at the Grammys. That's pretty elite company. Whitney Houston covered the song in 1990. It was a bonus track only released on the Japanese edition of her third album, I'm Your Baby Tonight. In 2019, Norwegian DJ Kygo reworked Whitney's cover and made it a house song. And it went number one on the Billboard Dance Chart. So I listened to it. It was pretty a little catchy. I liked it. I did listen to the 1990 cover as well from Whitney. She sounds good because it's Whitney. But they made it a little more 90s pop, New Jack Swing style, which I didn't love as much. It's not Winwood, and the Beast cannot be beaten in this case because he is the one who sang the best version of Higher Love.
He beat
Rob. He beat Whitney.
Whitney. That sounds bad. He beat Whitney.
Whitney.
Well, sorry, Bobby.
Sorry, Bobby. Yeah,
He beat you to it.
He beat you to it.
Damn it.
Dang it.
Bobby thought he was the first one.
Wow.
So, all right. So that was my pop.
This is a mess. This whole thing's a mess.
Solo song. That means we're on to Kurt's second pick. Sixth pick of the draft. Yeah, you have two in a row.
I had two in a row.
Are you going to go with the
I'm doing wild card first.
Wild card. Nice.
Do you have wild card?
I do. I'm ready. I'm ready for you.
So my wild card, I'm going to go with a little thrash metal.
Are you ready?
Wow. With the Master of Puppets.
Oh, my goodness.
It's a good pick.
Really good. I imagine six-year-old you prepping for a soccer game.
Oh, yeah. That's how I got ready.
Just getting ready with this.
I think this one was right before T-ball.
Oh.
Meanwhile,
whatever you're doing.
Yeah. He's getting warmed up with Steve Winwood over here.
That's right.
I mean, he inspires. This just gets you angry.
I mean, nothing better than a song about drugs to get a six-year-old hopped
right?
up. Ready to go.
You did live in Yakima.
I did.
So. That checks out.
I was.
So this was your... This is your wild card.
This is my wild card.
This is a fantastic song.
So good.
I looked at this song on my list. Ultimately, I took it off because I didn't listen to it in 86, so I was trying to stay true to make songs I listened to in 86. And I didn't listen to it.
Then I would have chosen six-year-old.
I got you.
Six-year-old.
We just established he was listening to it for T-ball.
Yeah, that's right.
Did you see him in the back seat? Mom, can you turn on
Master of Puppets?
Master of Puppets.
It's not about puppets, honey. But it's got puppets.
It's about puppets.
Just back there on a juice box.
I mean, I played this just to keep the Demogorgon bats just away.
Nice. Yay.
So good. All right. Keep it all away.
Metallica, Master of Puppets.
I mean, it was number two on the top 500 heavy metal songs of all time.
It's fantastic.
By Martin Popoffs.
Really good.
I read that it has been played. It's their most played song. They first played it in 85, December 31st of 85 in San Francisco. It is since then they've played it 1,718 times. It's been played at every one of their shows.
Why did you choose it?
I chose it because I like it.
I like it.
I like it.
I like it a lot.
I like it a lot.
I will say that
This is what the people show up for, our thorough information. I like it.
Hey, all right. You brought me on here. This is what you get. No, this one, I will honestly say I didn't listen to music a lot when I was a child, which is surprising.
Man,
but come on. I didn't listen to. I've only listened to music probably for about 6 years out of my life, to tell you the truth.
That seems like
I am
a
guy that will drive 5 hours with the radio off in silence.
Because
I don't get silence that often, so I love it.
I can't. I gotta have something going.
But I will say, I got into Metallica my freshman year in college. It could have been because of a lady.
Ooh, a lady.
But I will just leave it at that.
First of all, what kind of lady are you hanging out with then? deep into Master of Puppets. That's a wild lady.
She was deep into Metallica.
Wow.
But you would not know it by just looking at her. She looked like an innocent.
Oh, okay.
But and she had a dark side.
She went a little crazy behind closed doors. What's that? Some freaking the sheets, cleaning the streets, whatever it is.
We're making up stuff.
It works.
All right. Yeah. Well, that means you have your second pick here. It's your first pick of round three.
All right. I'm going to.
What category are you going with here?
I'm going to keep on rocking. So this is favorite rock song.
Jeez.
And I'm going to go with Keep Your Hands to Yourself by the Georgia Satellites.
Wow. Good one.
That is a really good
that
one.
That felt like a Rob. That felt like that had Rob written all over it.
I looked at it.
Written all over it.
All over it, but it's mine. I put that it gets you just from isn't right at the very beginning.
Is this the one where it goes,
Yeah.
I mean, it gets you right from the beginning. I'm not sure if it'll come up.
Yeah.
Nope.
No, we got
the breakdown.
I got a little change in my pocket going jingle lingle So, I mean, don't hand me no lines. Just keep your hands
to yourself.
Isn't the one that said in a Dolly Parton wig? Or, no, that's a different song.
That's a different song. Rob doesn't know what's going on.
But this one hit reach number two on the Hot 100.
The Deuce.
It stayed out of the number one because of Bon Jovi. Living on a prayer.
Bon Jovi.
Damn you, Bon Jovi.
So, all right. That means my third. This is my third. Yeah, it's my third pick. I'm going to go with, because it's my shortest category, I'm going to go with rock. I'm going to go rock group. Let's see if I can find, again, I've got like five. I'm running into the rock problem here. I've got like five I want to choose from, but I don't I don't know which one to go with. Talk amongst yourselves for a second.
Talk amongst yourselves.
As I look at the list, like you said, Bon Jovi's here. We got Survivor. We got Europe. There was a lot of rock in 1986. Poison's got AC/DC from your favorite Maximum Overdrive.
That's right.
You know who else is in there?
Who else is in there?
A little Van Halen. 5150.
Yeah, we're not gonna claim that. So I'm gonna go with this.
Ooh, a little Huey.
Hip to be square.
So yeah, my rock song's gonna be "Hip to Be Square" by Huey Lewis.
And the News. Don't forget the News.
I never forget the News. Me and the News, they know.
I mean, this is one group I know.
Yes.
This is one group. Everybody, they were big in the 80s.
You know, I like.
They had a string there.
I like that part right there. He says that he's watching what he eats. That's good on you, Huey. He's trying to stay in shape. He's got a lot of work to do on the tour.
That's right.
All right. He doesn't want to run into. He already had some ear problems, so you don't want to have any other. Like body type.
I read that he has perfect pitch.
Perfect pitch.
He can hear a sound. I don't know, a note.
A note. Yes.
And he can replicate it just from hearing it.
It's great. We witnessed that on the.
I didn't think we did
On the documentary.
I know, but I felt like
greatest night in pop.
I felt like he was struggling.
And well, then, no, because
Steve Perry had to come in and show him up.
Perry was just trying to, you know, encourage him a little bit. He got put on the spot. He wasn't supposed to have a solo.
Huey wasn't supposed to be in there.
Yeah, and then all of a sudden, you know, I mean, Steve
4 o'clock in the morning, he's got to do stuff.
Wow.
He's like, hey, Huey, check this out. Try that.
Yeah, yeah. You just want to get up here.
You need to. You're here. Shut up and go. You need to be here.
Poor guy. How do you, he just looks around like, I can't do that.
What do you want me to do?
Steve Perry.
And then I think wasn't Kenny helping him out? No, Kenny was just doing
Kenny
his own
was
thing.
Kenny's
on his own thing.
Yeah, he was.
And he was all good. All right.
He was out back with Waylon.
Steve was helping. No, yeah. Kenny was not hanging out with Waylon. Those two are not together.
I know we've said it before, but that's Kenny's, my favorite part is the line where she goes, "There, we done lost Waylon."
Kenny's crew in the 80s consisted of Christopher Cross and Michael McDonald. He's not hanging out with Waylon Jennings.
I bet you those guys could party, man.
I bet
those
you.
I bet Michael McDonald? Cross was a. I bet he was a party.
Christopher Cross?
I bet he's throwing him back.
All right. Yeah. Singing, listen to Sailing, tossing back tall, cold ones.
Yeah.
Takes me away. All right, Rob. That takes you to your third and fourth pick. You've got two in a row here.
Third and fourth?
Yeah, you get two in a row.
Golly.
Weird noises.
Okay.
You have plenty of time to get ready, so you shouldn't have any problems.
I know. I wasn't paying attention to my fourth.
We know that.
Okay, here's my third. My third comes from the synth category.
I like it. Oh, this was my second choice after West End Girls.
I love the Talking Heads.
I love this song. Literally right here, I can see it. Wild, Wild Life. I had it, my second choice. I was actually considering this around for Wild Card. I like the chorus. Oh, that's a great song.
Yeah. Okay, so this is Wild, Wild Life, Talking Heads, released August of 86. It was the band's third and last top 40 hit on the Billboard Hot 100. It's been described as quirky and typically fun. Billboard said that Talking Heads put a minimal post-new wave accompaniment to a bouncy sing-along tune. It won Best Group Video for the MTV Music Awards in 87. It is set in a 1960s. The video, if you remember the video, it's set like in like a karaoke bar type thing. And then the patrons lip sync to the songs and they're doing Madonna and Prince. And then actually there's a young John Goodman.
I watched it today.
On the video. Did you know Radiohead, who got together in 85, decided to name themselves after the Talking Heads song, Radiohead?
Oh.
Yeah, there you go. Nice. You just learned something.
I learned something every time I'm here with you.
Considered learned.
Oh, yeah, you just. All right. My next song.
This is a studio of learned doctors.
Is let me pull it up here real quick.
Okay.
Which category is it from?
Oh, it's coming from the rock category.
Walking on.
And here it is.
Good filler.
You needed some time. Who made who? Oh, you're gonna like this. The background on this is right up your alley. This reminds me of the old laser light show at OMSI.
Yeah.
You know about the laser light shows?
No.
You didn't have those in Yakima?
No, we just had bullets flying by.
Not the same thing. Pretty close.
That's the same
thing. To be fair, where OMSI was, there was a chance that could happen too.
Oh, yeah. This is true. This is a song called Who Made Who? It's by AC/DC, Australian hard rock band. Taken from their 86 album, Who Made Who? It was one of only three new tracks on Who Made Who because the album is not only a soundtrack to which movie, Kurt?
Kurt?
Oh, I do not know.
It has trucks want to kill everyone.
Ooh.
Emilio.
I don't know.
Emilio!
He knows. He's just being a turd is what his problem is.
I like this movie.
I don't know.
It's Stephen King's Maximum Overdrive.
You don't like that movie.
That's
I do.
Horrible movie.
Yeah, it's a great movie.
Oh, it's bad.
But so it's not only... It's a soundtrack to the movie,
okay.
But it's also a compilation album featuring tracks from previous albums. It peaked at number 23 on the Billboard mainstream rock chart, and it stayed on the chart for 12 weeks. Did you know Bon Scott's early morning ritual was to gargle with red wine and honey?
Yes.
To help retain the raspy edge to his voice.
And why did Bon Scott pass away?
Probably drugs. I'm gonna
go. Maybe. I think he
drank himself to death. So
I'm going to go with.
Maybe we should be gargling red wine first thing in the morning, right?
A guzzle.
No, stop saying that word. Okay.
Guzzle?
Yeah, I don't like
gargle.
That word. Gargle? No, none of them.
Gargle a nice cold.
They all sound bad.
Budweiser.
All right, so you had your round three and round four picks. Yeah. Just as a recap, what were they again, Rob?
Three and four?
Yes.
Talking Heads, Wild Wildlife, beautiful. And Who Made Who, AC/DC.
So that takes your new wave and your rock off the board, right?
Yeah. Yes.
All right,
yes,
so
yes,
that yes. Brings
so I got
it.
Solo and Wild Left.
You do. Yeah. Wild Card.
My Wild Card.
Yes. So I'm going to, that's my turn. So, there's so many songs. Kurt said before this started, he's like, there's hundreds of songs. It's so hard to choose. I've got so many I want to play.
What categories you got left?
So I've got number one song, I've got pop group, and I've got wild card.
Ooh,
so
you do have some.
I'm going to go with pop group here.
Okay.
Ooh, and this is a song that to me just sounds like 1986. Rob looks confused. He doesn't know this one.
Oh, he knows this.
No, he doesn't. Every now and again, you catch him. Maybe when they get a little more of the chorus, Rob will figure it out. Even the movie hound knows it. So right, I wouldn't be So what do you think of that, Rob?
I like it.
You like it?
Yeah.
He likes it.
The name is escaping me, but I know the song.
You know the song.
You're driving me nuts.
Were you trying to look it up? You were doing some frantic something over there.
No, so I'm
trying to figure out what you were doing.
He's just running the soundboard.
Well, this is Something About You.
Okay.
By the band Level 42.
Oh, see? Nope.
Yeah.
Actually, this was released in September of 85, so slow climber up the charts. Didn't hit the top 10 until May and first week of June of 86, and finished on the year-end Hot Billboard 100 at number 37. In fact, it was on the Billboard chart for 72 weeks, selling over a million copies. So that's a long time for it to sit around on that. Name of the band was inspired by the book The Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy, in which the answer to a question about the meaning of life is 42. So, have you seen that movie?
I tried to watch it. I couldn't get into it.
Alan Rickman, particularly funny. So, fun fact, Robbie, you're going to like this one. The great late drummer.
You assume I'm going to like it.
I do. The late great drummer of the Foo Fighters, Taylor Hawkins, was a big Level 42 fan, particularly this song. And in 2022, Level 42 played a tribute to Taylor with Justin Hawkins, who is not related to Taylor. Justin Hawkins is the lead singer of a band called The Darkness, but was very good friends with Taylor.
Okay.
So,
I like that song a lot.
Yeah.
Yep. I overlooked that one.
Wow.
Yeah. I just was never on my list.
How can you overlook that?
I know. I'm kind of bumming.
I thought you looked at all of 1986.
Every single song you listened to.
Feel bad now, don't you?
Well, I mean, I mean,
does it sound more 80s?
I'm gonna sleep well tonight. We're gonna leave the studio, and I'm gonna forget about everything we've done here.
Multiple Rolling Rocks deep, you're gonna sleep just fine.
Just fine.
So I guess that means we're back to the top, which in this round is the bottom. No, yeah. So the ninth pick. This is the 12th pick.
It's my next pick.
In round four.
I don't know.
Yeah, because you should have three picks left, right?
I do have three.
Okay, so this is the 12th pick in round four, so you get the next two.
All right. So I'm going to go with the favorite new wave synth pop song.
Okay.
And I am going with Human from the Human League.
It's really good.
It's really good.
You know, your list is pretty good. You said at the beginning about your list is strong.
Well, you might have noticed every song is on the radio.
That's my third. This was my third new wave option in case you two took West End Girls. And, of course, Rob did take Wild Wild Life.
And I did have West End Girls as one of my top two. So.
Yeah. So, actually, no. I had this lower than that. I lied. I have no reason why. I didn't look at my list right.
But he's lying.
I did.
He was trying to make me feel better that it was higher on his list. You know what? No, I don't care.
It's still really good. There were just a lot of really good new wave songs in 86 that I had.
That's what he used to do when he played basketball when we were growing up. He was like, oh, you're doing really good.
He did do really good.
Thanks, Dad.
And then he'd let me win.
So this is from the fifth studio album, Crash.
Didn't let it
Came out in 1986. The subject deals with infidelity.
Oh,
yes.
Ooh.
It topped the chart in the United States, becoming the band's second single to be on number one in the Billboard Hot 100 after their 81 single, Don't You Want Me.
Ooh.
It also went to number one in Canada, five in Germany, and eight in the band's native United Kingdom.
Wow.
So apparently us Americans in Canada liked them better than their own country.
Yeah.
I just put it's a very dramatic video.
The UK,
What's
fans
the video?
I
haven't seen.
They're thickle. Like there's drops into like water, and they're just standing there staring as the drops in the water.
That was a very 80s thing to do. Yeah. Lots of water. Everything was wet.
Do you feel like it was very dramatic?
Wet. It was very dramatic.
It was dramatic.
Okay. It was very good.
I like right. it.
Okay,
as
my
you said,
next
earlier.
One.
Ooh, now, this is your.
My next one is. Let's see here. Which category do I have?
Ooh, yeah, left? You have two categories left. What two categories do you have left?
Ooh, I have favorite male, female, pop, and favorite number one. So we're going favorite male, female, pop.
Ooh, I like it.
Let's see here. Who did I have? What did I have?
Oh, he doesn't even know
I
anymore.
I don't remember.
Come on, Rob.
Oh, yes.
Dave's going to like this one.
Oh, let's see.
Okay, I went with, I got to get to my notes. There it is. I went with Mad About You from Belinda Carlisle.
Oh, that's a really good one. Huh, Rob?
That's right.
You can dance like this.
I like Belinda Carlisle.
It's a white guy dance.
Right. I was going to say, I put, she was nice on the ass for a six-year-old.
Nice on the ass.
Yes, for a six-year-old, but really liked it. But I will say that I'm main reason why I got this one, I was telling my wife this morning about, you know, I don't really, I'm not the muse, I don't do music a lot.
Uh-huh.
the reasons why I don't do music a lot, I was the youngest of four children.
Okay.
So I never got to choose radio or TV stations or anything like that. So it was whatever was playing because somebody else chose it.
Oh.
And this one was a heavy rotation play.
Heavy rotation.
Probably because of my two older sisters. So
nice.
It came out of that. This is Belinda Carlisle, like I said. She was the lead vocalist of the Go-Go's.
So you can blame your sisters for being
That's right.
That is correct.
So apparently David said it was okay, so my sisters had okay taste.
No, this is a good song. Anything Belinda Carlisle sings is gold.
It's so, gold, Jerry.
You can't really go wrong with that, right?
All right.
So that means it's...
so far, I haven't had a turd, so that's good.
No, your list is really good.
Right. So you had two in a row there.
I got one left.
Yeah. What's your last category?
My last category is favorite number one, and I saved the best for last for you guys.
I bet you did. What was the two songs you just took again? You have Belinda Carlisle, Mad About You.
And Human.
Human. Very good for your synth pop. Well, I have
Human League.
I have two categories left. I have number one song. I have Wild Card. Ugh. I think I'm going to go number one song. I'm pretty sure I could probably leave this because I don't think either of you will take it. But I don't want to risk it. So I'm just going to go ahead and take it.
To the limit.
It's going to be, yeah. So this is my number one song.
I almost picked it. Picked it just to be an ass.
Do you realize?
Did you think about it?
I have it on the first one on my list.
Do you realize? This draft, I've gotten Steve Winwood and Peter Cetera. This has been the best draft ever. It's just been fantastic.
Because you got everything you want.
Let's just listen for a second.
We've heard it.
Mm.
What is this song? I've never heard of it. Keep playing it.
Wait. I think the piano is a little undersold.
He's not cool enough.
Doesn't it have a saxophone solo?
Oh, yeah. There's just not enough time for the saxophone. And I want to tease the folks at home, so they'll go find it, and then they'll be able to have a little fun with it. So one of my favorite songs of the 80s. You know this, Rob.
I know it.
The Movie Hound knows this. Yeah. Karate Kid.
Your wife loves this song.
Karate Kid 2. Everybody knows. She's less excited than I am.
Of all things.
So. First single after Peter left Chicago. We highlighted in the past, it was originally written for Rob, Rocky IV, but Stallone said no.
Yeah.
So then it ended up Karate Kid 2, which was the right call. It's better for Karate Kid 2.
Yeah.
Not only was this number one on the Billboard Hot 100, but shockingly, you're going to be surprised, Rob.
I don't think I'm going to.
Also number one on the Adult Contemporary chart. It was nominated.
How did it make it on that one?
Oh, man. Nominated for an Oscar and a Golden Globe, but lost both. To Berlin's Take My Breath Away. Tough one, right? Also nominated for a Grammy for Best Male Pop Vocal, but lost to The Beast, Higher Love, Steve Winwood. It's tough. You can't, I can't split hairs there. Everybody wins. He got nominated, Steve Winwood won. It's win-win, Rob.
Win-win.
Win-win.
Everybody wins with the win-win.
That's a lot of W's.
That's a lot of W's. So that means we're going to Rob's last... Two picks.
But do I have two? I do have two.
Yeah, you.
Okay.
This should be the 15th and 16th pick.
Yes. Okay.
What two categories do you have left?
I've got solo.
Okay, for pop music.
So yeah, I've got solo.
Solo.
And then I've got my wild card.
We've all been waiting for the wild card.
I know. Yeah. All right. So here's my my solo.
Yes.
Is. I love this song.
Oh, we went with Anita.
I love her voice.
Another love song. Still prepping that anniversary.
I was going to say, were you making a mixtape?
Silky smooth.
You were doing this?
Yeah. Silky smooth voice. I love this.
Mixed. Hey, we've hit all the checklists. Mixtape.
Listen to that voice.
Here we go. Mixtape, Bon Vinos.
Yeah.
Now, Rob.
Yes.
What kind of song is this?
This is a booty jam.
This is a booty jam.
Yeah.
When you put this song on.
It's a 1986. But listen to her voice. She's so good.
No one listens to this while vacuuming. You put this song on. There's only one purpose left.
It's on my treadmill.
He puts it on. He does naked vacuuming. Really puts his wife in the mood.
That's horrible. When you vacuum, a lot of things are moving around.
She says stop.
Can you imagine? You know,
I try not to. I don't know.
In the late 90s, you know, you meet Rob. You end up back at his place. He's like, oh, you want me to put a little music on?
It's good.
Where'd your shirt go? And then it's immediate.
And then I lock all the doors.
Turns so they on, can't get out.
So they can't get out.
Turned on his two lava lamps.
And then I had a bed that turned.
Oh. Yeah,
it was cool.
Beehive. Yeah,
it was cool. He fell over.
Hey, multiple times. We've had a lot of Austin Powers today.
So this is Anita Baker. She's ranked number 74 on VH1's 100 Greatest Women in Rock and Roll.
Ever.
The name of the song is Sweet Love.
Why'd you say it like that? Did you imagine that? It's like 2 in the morning. You're listening to the radio. Hey, ladies and gentlemen, this is Sweet Love.
That's right.
He thinks he's the ladies' man or something. Yeah.
This is American R&B singer Anita Baker, co-written by Anita Baker, released in May of 86. It was her first big hit, peaked at number 2, reached number 3 on the U.S. Billboard Adult Contemporary chart.
Beautiful.
It reached number 8 on the U.S. Billboard Hot 100. It won the Grammy Award for Best R&B Song at the 29th Grammy Awards in 87. Also, the album containing this song, Rapture, won the category for Best Female R&B Vocal Performance. So she did very well at the 87 Grammys. It's been described as Baker's voice has been described as ringing like a bell, and it sounds like old love sonnets brought back to life. Ooh. Which I really like it. So yeah. Anyway, so I just, old her voice is sonnet. Killer. Mm-hmm. I love it. Okay.
Now, what was the name of that song again, Rob?
It's called Sweet Love.
Do the Barry White.
Barry White. Sweet Love. Sweet Love. So you don't want a fish sandwich?
That was a long shot.
Whoa.
What?
What?
Hello. Hey,
oh. Oh, my goodness.
Okay. Time out.
All right. This is your last.
This is my last one.
This is your last song?
Yeah. And this is what people have been
waiting for.
This is your wild card?
From this.
Yeah. Will anybody recognize
this? This is the one where Rob's excited because he got to throw away the reins of the rules.
That's right.
And just look around.
Okay, so the only people I think that will know this are our friends over at the Pop Culture Yearbook. I think they're going to know this.
Okay.
But here we go.
Okay.
The R.E.M., huh?
It is R.E.M.
Yep. Was 9-year-old Rob really... deep into some REM.
No. He was.
No, that's why I picked it. Because it
for Halloween.
I found it later.
For Halloween, he went as Michael Stipe. Shaved his head. Holding. And when he go to trick or treat at the door, he just looked real concerned.
Yes.
Trick or treat.
Shiny, happy people.
That song wasn't out yet, Rob.
I know. It wasn't.
Otherwise, you would be some sort of genius, some sort of Nostradamus.
Nostradamus.
Michael, in your future, I see a terrible pop song.
Nostradamus?
Shiny, happy people.
Is it Nostradamus?
Nostradamus. I think there's a little thing above the O. Nostradamus.
No.
Well, you would say nostril. But so Nostradamus.
There's no thing about there's like an umlaut.
What are you trying to say?
What
his
are you
name
both
is?
Talking about?
What are you? No. First of all, now we have to clear this up. What are you trying to say his name is?
I thought it was Nostradamus.
It's Nostradamus. Why would you carry that O so hard?
I don't know.
I'm a hard O guy. I'm a Nostradamus.
I think it's a Nostradamus.
I think it's an O blank E. So you
Nostradamus.
Say
the umlaut?
No. There's no umlaut.
What about the Oxford comma? Is that there?
What is an Oxford comma?
You're it's making an educated crap up. Comma. Isn't that an educated comma?
You're making stuff up.
I think I'm just giving you some, English stuff that you've forgotten.
People don't care.
As a teacher. So.
Oh, I don't teach English.
I still think it's Nostradamus.
Yeah. Okay, whatever.
We'll ask anyone out there if you want to chime in.
Nostradamus, Nostradamus, whatever.
It's not apples and oranges. All right. So.
Potato. This is a song called Fall on Me.
Fall on Me.
By.
Nostradamus.
REM. It's from their fourth album, Life's Rich Pageant.
No.
I found this album actually at Goodwill.
Ooh.
And I was like 99 cents or something. So nice. I was like, I'll check it out. And I really like it. It's really good.
When did you find this at Goodwill?
Do that. You don't know. I often do that. I'll go buy. I just found.
I understand that. I'm asking when. Was it last week?
I don't know.
Was it a year ago? Was it 5 years ago?
I don't know. Year ago?
Yeah. You so, didn't hear this till a year ago?
No. I hadn't heard this album. Nice. You always hear, like, you know, music for the people. And you hear you know.
She but didn't hear this one.
No, not this one. Okay. So anyway, it's from that album. It was the first of two singles released from that LP. The subject is about acid rain.
Of course.
Ooh, yeah. Acid rain. It peaked at number 94 in the Billboard Hot 100, so barely reached the Hot 100. The song was one of the band's early compositions about environmentalism. Considered a more accessible sound. They have kind of a duet that's really Stipe and Mike Mills. They sing back and forth. Michael Stipe once described the song as pretty much a song about oppression.
Uh-huh.
And then later he said it was, and then Billboard said it was hum-worthy and top 40 compatible, though the subliminal stuff is there too. Did you know, this is not about this song, that Shiny Happy People was the original theme for Friends? However, the band turned it down.
Ooh.
Good.
So apparently, Michael Stipe will not be there for you.
No, he will not.
Really? He's somewhere else.
That's a good play on words.
You like that?
Right?
Hey. All right.
How does that song start?
Which one?
Shiny Happy People.
And it's like a stupid, it's like a, got a little, like,
a triangle.
A little thing.
You're showing triangle sound. Yeah, there's
like a xylophone. I was thinking this, like a xylophone, like it's weird.
Come and get it type of thing.
I don't know.
Accordion?
No accordion.
Yeah. Okay. No. So that means
what is going on?
What? I'm just asking about shiny. Wait a minute. Here we go.
Rob,
what is going on?
Now what?
Oh man.
We want to know how
it starts.
How it starts, right? Yeah,
it has like is a piano. Is there some kind of an instrument? It opens up.
It usually is something.
And that's usually how it starts. What do you want that to be?
It's some kind of...
You know, for all the REM I do like, I don't like this.
This is a weird song.
It's just not good.
Some strings.
But it gets going. What about the... Hey, and you know what makes it worse? Maybe the B-52 lady.
Oh, yeah.
She's not helping.
Yeah. And it's not a happy song. It's about, like, the in China. The Tiananmen Square.
The Tiananmen Square?
Yeah. Because they had these posters up and they talked about... it was like propaganda, and they said people need to be shiny, happy people, and so the song's actually not happy.
It sounds happy.
Yeah, well, it's not.
I put a smile on my face.
It sounds too happy.
I think that's the point.
But we had to play it because Rob didn't know how it started.
That's right.
So, well, that was a good one.
Don't blame me for this debacle that this has turned into.
Blame me. I'm usually not on the music.
I wanted to know how shiny.
You've done very
well.
You've behaved yourself. He did everything he's supposed to. Everybody's all like,
What was your last two songs?
Oh, my last two were...
Actually, save that. We're going to sum it up when we go, once Curtis and I have finished.
All right.
So that means I have wild card. I'm going to be honest with you. I have like four songs I would like to play for wild card. So maybe I'll just play them all.
Well, don't steal
but
my
But that's
last
not one. In the rules of drafting. So, what do you have left? Number one song.
I have number one.
Yeah. The songs that I'm looking at were not number one songs.
You don't listen to number ones.
No. I listen to number ones. But this... It is not garbage. This song is fantastic. So I'm just going to finish. I think I've looked at all of it. I'm going to finish the triad. I've gotten Peter Cetera. I've gotten Steve Winwood. So, Rob, there's only one person left.
What? Michael McDonald. Oh.
Oh.
Oh, my goodness. Michael.
Don't hurt me, Michael.
Oh, did you hear the horns in there? Come on, Rob.
The horns make him horny.
Oh.
I do like that horn. That was pretty good.
Oh. You hear the bass in his voice? And then he hits that alto afterwards? True treasure of a voice, Rob.
Dropping music now. She's like,
alto or whatever.
I mean,
we don't know these things.
I think we're just going to listen to the whole song. Says it's 7 minutes and 39 seconds. Michael won't sue me. It'll be fine. He wants me to have a good time. Oh,
to Michael.
Maybe we can hear one more bridge before we shut him down. Here we go.
Was this
Don't
movie?
You feel Yeah, it is. Don't you just feel good hearing this song?
I was feeling good and then
I was feeling good.
Oh, let's horns one more time.
Wow.
Oh.
People have had
He's
enough.
Bouncing in that chair like he feels it in his plums.
Oh, it's all the way down there. My goodness, this is Sweet Freedom by Michael McDonald. So, yes, I've completed the triad. Cetera.
The triad.
Winwood. McDonald. I mean, there's no better probably threesome you could come up with than that right there. So let's see. Awesome song from the Billy Crystal and Gregory Hines buddy cop movie, Running
That's
Scared.
What it was.
Yes, Running Scared.
Because they're in the video.
Oh, they are.
Yes.
In the video, Mike's wearing a badass Hawaiian shirt. Looks real good. Mm-hmm. And Gregory Hines is rocking a Walter Payton half-shirt jersey. He wanted to show off the abs. Gregory was looking good in the 80s. Mm-hmm. He wanted to flex. Billy Crystal not showing off the abs. Yeah, no. So Billy wasn't maybe he wasn't hitting the six-pack as good as Gregory was. But wasn't Gregory a tap dancer?
I think
he was a famous tap dancer. Like, so that automatically burns more calories than Billy Crystal. I mean, it's just science.
Than stand-up comedy.
Yeah, it's science. Comedy.
It's science.
It's science. Let's see.
You're like marvelous.
What's not to love here, Rob? You got Mike on the keyboard.
Nah.
Awesome horns to include that solo horn you loved so much.
You didn't find out who was on the horns?
Well, no. It's just a backup band. Nobody in general.
Studio.
Soothing vocals of the voice that is.
Soothing.
Michael McDonald. Man, that sounds good. A lot of bro love in this video. Mike's hugging Billy and Gregory. They're slamming back some brews. They're dancing together.
Brewskies.
It was a good video. They look like they're in the islands.
Yeah,
I think young Flanagan might be getting them some drinks.
Flanagan. Oh, man.
Oh, this is the breakdown, right?
Oh, it's the breakdown.
I was waiting.
I thought we were done. And, I thought we'd had enough.
No, there's kind of this where it breaks a little.
I hope it doesn't sound like that.
So good. All right.
Keep that woo woo to yourself.
Wow. Don't it again. No, I don't. No.
I do a good Michael McDonald. I've been told many times.
No, you've never.
Yeah, I've been told. Yeah. Just walk up to the random. I go up to random people on the street. Password freedom.
And they go, "Oh, Michael McDonald.
Oh, yeah,
that's really good.
Thank you.
That's not what he sounds like.
Stupid. That's exactly what it sounds like.
Oh goodness.
Hey, you want to see the funniest thing ever?
What?
On Jimmy Fallon, he had him, Justin Timberlake, and Michael McDonald, and they did a round, and Jimmy and Justin Timberlake are impersonating him really well.
Yeah, because they're funny.
And they do "Row, Row Your Boat." So "Row, Row, Row Your Boat," and all three of them together, it's great. So YouTube that. Have fun with it. We're just going to do this the rest of the podcast.
No, we're not.
I think I have one
more choice.
Yeah, he's
going to. You're going to love it.
I know I'm going to love it, but I feel like we should just not play any more music because Michael seems to be the apex of this choices of 1986.
Yeah,
I don't know any song
I'm
going to
spoil
be
it for everybody.
So, hold on.
We're ending this podcast with Michael McDonald song. I already know it. I can see it in his eyes.
He's going to play it on the outro.
We're going to walk out of here
to
Michael McDonald.
I mean,
he already had that the minute he played the stupid song.
Do a lot worse. I mean, there's a lot of options. You know, Steve was in here. I mean, the Beast has been in the studio today. Satara. I mean, Karate Kid 2. What do we got? We got everything.
Did they ever do a song together, the three of them?
Who's that? No.
Winwood.
That would have been.
That's too much power.
I don't
the world
think,
can't handle it.
Yeah, I don't think the human ears could really take it. Like, I think heads would just explode. That would be happening. Oh, it's too much. You could somehow get Kenny Loggins into that group, too. Just be an orgy of the best 80s music you've ever heard in your life right there.
So. Wow.
A couple years back, there was a tour. Loggins, Cross, and McDonald. I didn't see it, but that would have been just... I can't even fathom.
Did you just use the phrase... an orgy of the best
voices of the 80s. Voices of the
80s. He did.
Satara, Loggins, McDonald, Winwood.
Winwood.
All right.
Okay.
Yes.
See me.
Wow.
Right. I want to hear his choice.
We're going to hear his choice. He's not going anywhere. All right.
I've been locked in the studio for an hour now.
I feel like we have to give Michael McDonald enough attention. is deserved for him.
So everybody at home.
Yes.
There's a little 10-second skip ahead button on your phone. Nope. When you're listening to a podcast, you can just do that.
It's too late now.
Not
they've
when
already
you're talking about
the Winwood.
Like right now, now.
Not when you're talking about Michael McDonald.
Too late.
Never
too late.
Fast forward for
it's
Michael.
It's too late now.
Yeah.
All right, Kurt. Let's move it along.
All right.
All right. So this is your last choice.
My last. It's
this
the
is
last
your
choice.
Number one song. Lots of good number one songs. I'm very excited
it's
to hear
this.
It's
not my number one song. It is a number one song.
It is your favorite number one song.
Well.
Which is why you're drafting it. Unless someone took your favorite. Did someone take your favorite?
Or I'm choosing it just to simply enjoy the laughter that may bring.
Do we have it queued up, Rob?
We do.
All right, let's hear it.
All right, go for it.
why are you turning it off?
I didn't turn it off. I have it all the way up. And it's...
I wonder what if I got the right version for you.
Oh, yeah, this you got the really slow stripped down version.
This might be the B-side.
Yeah, this is... let's check with Kip again. I don't think that's the original 86
version. As we're checking in, that version. Is, of course, you already know it. It is True Colors by one Miss Cyndi Lauper.
Ooh.
Everybody loves Cyndi. I haven't heard Cyndi on your guys' podcast yet.
You
talked a little bit about her.
We are not huge Cyndi folks.
I know you love her solo Kip's and We Are the World.
Kip's given the
all. Kip's, Maybe that was the right version.
No, what's he doing?
Kip, it's fine. We get the gist.
I see your true colors shining through. I will say this is another one that was on heavy replay on MTV in my house. Yeah. My sister's watching. And it's just I sing it every time it comes on when I'm in my car by myself.
Do you
if
really?
I have the radio on.
Do you really?
I do.
Oh, that's right, because you sit in silence.
When I'm not sitting in silence, if it comes on,
just do it
I will sing it.
Just hit it.
I will. All right, so this is, of course, number one, because this is from the number ones. It is...
It's the just same. Loves it.
As this goes on nicely, it spent 2 weeks at number one on the Billboard Hot 100. It's her second and last single to occupy the top chart. This song was a Grammy Award nomination.
That's good.
Wow.
Only lost to Barbara Streisand.
Who, Bob? That's a bag
Barbara
of trash.
Best female pop vocal
all,
performance.
Who's losing to Barbara Streisand in 1986?
You want to know who's losing? Madonna is losing.
Oh, wow.
Tina Turner is losing.
It's ridiculous.
Dionne Warwick is losing.
Ridiculous.
And so is Cyndi Lauper.
Well, that's fair because Dionne Warwick won for that. He beat out Simply Red.
Oh, yeah.
So it's all fair.
Yeah, cue that
it's
one.
All fair. It's all fair and love and war.
I want to hear. That's a friend of all.
No.
Yeah.
To bring this back to the 80s, though, Cyndi Lauper, I was a big wrestling fan,
came out
at the original
Captain
WrestleMania.
Captain Lou Albano?
Yep.
Are we going Albano or Albano?
Albano.
Bano.
He's not an Albano.
Rob the umlaut on that one, too?
I don't know.
Albano. Albano.
I just know he had rubber bands in his beard.
And a lot of rubber bands. He was in the Girls Just Want to Have Fun video.
He was.
And to wrap this even more into 86, 1986 was, Rob's got something. What the heck is this? No. We're still talking about Cyndi. What's going on with your feed? This is a terrible version.
What do you mean?
Faux show.
What is happening
now? 86 was the first time I really watched, I watched the World Series. And that was that Mets, Red Sox World Series, the Buckner thing, all that. At the end of the World Series, they played a montage of the whole series with the Mets on all their clips, True Colors. Cyndi Lauper. People are crying. I was crying at home. No, I wasn't crying. But
it was
quite the thing.
I believe it.
So.
It's a moving song.
All right. So well,
it makes my eyeballs ring.
So you had Cyndi Lauper, True Colors.
That's right.
That's your number one hit.
That's my number one.
Good
number
song.
One.
So we're gonna go around the table.
Okay.
And we're going to talk about and sum up again the choices that you had and include the category, Rob.
Oh.
Yes. So let's start with the man who had the number three pick. We'll start with Roboito and see what he's got. So sum up again what you had.
You want my whole pick? My whole roster.
What's your list?
Whole list. Okay.
Give
so
us a recap.
My number one pick was Sade Adu with Sweetest Taboo.
Yes.
Yes. And that came out of the group duet
pop category.
Yeah. Number two was Simply Red. Holding Back the Years, that came out of the number one category. Mm,
really good.
I had Talking Heads' Wild, Wild Life, that came out of the synth pop category. I had Who Made Who at number four. AC/DC, that came out of the rock category. My number five was Sweet as Love by Anita Baker.
Sweet Love.
And that came out of solo category.
Solo.
And then my number six was my wild card, and that was R.E.M. Fall on Me.
What song were you most excited to have been able to draft today?
Oh, Sade.
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 Really?
Yeah, I like that song.
He's the sweetest kind of Sade. Yeah.
Okay. Why was Sade the
good,
best?
Because I like her.
You know what I am upset about? Now, well, before we get to Mike and Kurt's list, this song didn't get drafted.
Gross.
No, it's good.
Gross.
No, I don't like this.
This is Patti LaBelle.
I don't care.
But it's not... just Patti LaBelle.
This is David's love life through the
this
90s.
This is featuring... Wait. So many
promises. I knew he was going to come back.
How did no one draft this? Beautiful duet. Michael McDonald.
Because as you say, it's a bag of garbage.
Oh. Wow. That gets you in the feels. All right.
No, it doesn't.
I can't believe that'd get drafted by anybody. I thought for sure that would be your group pop duet.
Bro. Oh, yeah.
I thought
that
for sure.
Michael McDonald.
So, okay. So I'll go side the second pick.
Yeah.
So for New Wave, I had West End Girls.
Yeah, that was a good first
Head pick. Shop Boys.
Damn it.
Number one song I went with, oh, man, Glory of Love, Peter Cetera.
Yeah, yeah, we're all really sad you picked that.
Yeah. Pop solo, I had Higher Love. Mm-hmm. By the Beast, Steve Winwood.
Yeah.
Pop group, I went with Level 42. If you remember that one, Rob, what was the name of that song? Because you had forgotten about it.
It was called
Come On.
I'm a Big Dumb Idiot.
something About You.
Yeah,
there you go.
Yeah.
My rock group, I had Huey Lewis in the News with Hip to Be Square.
Yeah.
And for my wild card, the one and the only, Michael McDonald with that Sweet Freedom.
Oh, you're going to play it again?
Nope. This is just this one.
It's just this one.
I really wanted this for Wild Card too, but I just couldn't fit it in.
Oh, goodness.
Did you know that Poor Huey Patti Lewis LaBelle. In the News was originally called Huey Lewis in the American Express?
Ooh. Did that work?
I don't know. It didn't work. But then here's the other thing. They both came from two bands. They came from the ashes of two bands. One was called Clover.
Crimson?
And the other one was called Soundhole.
Crimson and
Soundhole.
What an awful
Soundhole.
Name.
That's what we're creating right now.
Yes.
Soundhole.
So that means...
they'll give anybody
Let's do your Soundhole and find, recap your list
All right.
For us there.
My first pick was Walk This Way by the Run DMC and Aerosmith.
Oh, that was a good
That's
one.
A really good one.
Yeah. And then I went... My wild card was Master of Puppets with Metallica.
Mm.
Ooh.
My third pick, I went in the rock category still with Keep Your Hands to Yourself by the Georgia Satellites.
Mm-hmm. That was that's the one I didn't expect that one from you today. That's Sorry. The one that surprised me.
Sorry.
I thought Living on a Prayer, you said you were the radio guy, so Living on a Prayer. Oh. I thought for sure that Survivor's song might have a chance because it was in Rocky IV. And being a movie guy, I thought maybe that
Sorry to disappoint.
I know.
But I changed it up a
little
bit.
I am disappointed.
All right, my fourth choice
feels like the whole thing's messed up.
Was the new wave synth pop? I went with Human from the Human League.
Ooh, good.
Ooh, your list is pretty solid.
And then favorite male female pop song? I went with Mad About You by Belinda Carlisle.
I am confident to say you have the second best list. Confident.
And my favorite number one was your guys' favorite, True Colors by one Miss Cyndi Lauper.
Yes. Actually, that's the only one where. You know,
that's the one I picked just for funsies.
Yeah, so good list, very good. Actually, we all had really good lists. Your list is good too, Rob.
Oh, thanks.
I do like your list.
I am quite a musical guy.
Did you know
I'm named after a music band?
A music band. You know, here's another song
that
didn't get drafted.
Who are you named after? Say that.
Curtis Blow.
No. I am named after Casey and the Sunshine Band.
That's right.
You're not.
Yes, he is. My dad loved Casey and the Sunshine Band.
Oh.
So he wanted to call me Casey. So the whole thing was he wanted my first and middle initial to be Casey.
You can
so my name is Kurt Christopher.
Hey, you know, I like what you did there. We got to shorten that. My middle inish.
My middle inish.
I don't want to do. It's like a Tenacious D thing. It's my middle inish.
So they went with Kit Carson originally. Originally, it was supposed to be Kit Carson.
Kit Kardashian.
They went with Kurt Christopher.
Kit Carson would be killer.
That would have been killer.
My dad's entire life never called me Casey once.
Oh. Well, that's okay. At least he tried.
He tried.
He got you named after it.
He got me named after Casey and the Sunshine Band.
That's a cool story. So, I did not
good
know
list.
That.
That is a cool story. That is cool, Stu.
Yeah.
That
is good. All right.
By the way, another song. Oh, another song that I can't believe.
If it has
believe,
Michael McDonald in it, I'm walking out of here.
No one
I'm going to take
I'm
my
in front
headphones
of the door.
Off.
He can't get out.
Can't believe nobody took this.
Oh, New Shoes.
It's like one of the best pop songs of the 80s.
You got a pair of new shoes.
We got new shoes.
We're going to get us the new shoes.
Wait.
Why do you dance like that?
Those of you on YouTube are seeing a lot of David's dance moves.
Ooh, a little Portland zone.
Watch out.
Did you just...
How did this not get picked?
He was almost breaking as good as that Australian lady there for a second.
Ray Gun.
I get 0 points.
I love Ray Gun.
You get
he goes by Frozone 2.
You get 0 points.
Frozone 2. I love it.
Oh. All right.
Just doing my thing.
Just doing your thing. All right. So what did you think of in the end? What did you think of everybody's list? Or what did you think of your own list? What was your final analysis, Rob?
I really liked them. Yeah, I got the songs I wanted.
Was there any songs you were like, I wouldn't have taken that one?
No, wouldn't have or would?
Wouldn't have.
No, I like
see?
Him. Yeah.
So he would have taken Michael McDonald. All this nonsense you gave.
No, on this perfect. List, on your list, no, bag of garbage.
All of our lists. Not, garbage. I'm not taking. Said all of our lists.
Michael, no. Yeah, he had, West End Girls I want. I wanted that one. I
had a little sneeze.
That was weird.
That's a weird noise.
That was like a sneeze and a hiccup.
He's always good for a good
little I was trying to hold the sneeze noise. In so it didn't explode.
You got really excited. How do you do that? And just, you just swallowed a
I suppressed it. I channel my inner Michael McDonald.
Oh, wow. I've never seen that before in my life.
Wow.
So, all right. Kurt. What is your? How did you feel about the draft, Kurt?
I wanted Master of Puppets you, too. That's it.
Yeah, Master of Puppets, really good.
I got all of my songs.
You did all I of did. Them. Good. The True Colors is the only one I wouldn't have taken, but I see. I understand the. I understand the nostalgia and attachment to it.
Plus, I know how you guys feel about Cindy and her lovely.
I don't feel anything about Cindy. It's just not. You my brought favorite.
Up her solo multiple times in conversation.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Oh, for rough. The well, it was
for the rough. We Are the World. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
Wow. Wow.
There's no way Quincy Jones was like, "Yeah, do that again."
Yeah, that's perfect.
Run well, it right back.
She did it every time they rehearsed, and so
but they had
he
to
did say, "Do it again."
Lionel, she's not singing very good. I imagine that's the conversation in the corner with Michael. You know, so we had Steve Perry teaching Huey. You got him talking over here.
Yeah, that is.
Waylon's awesome. Done. Got Waylon's done. Lost done.
I don't swing no Swahili.
That's right. We done lost Waylon.
We done lost him. So, all right. Well, I think all the lists were good. I think everybody made some good choices. That Wild Wild Life, that was, I really considered that possibly for the wild card. Sweet Freedom was second to that, as much as I love Michael McDonald. I do love that. A couple other songs I really wanted to get, and I couldn't go away from Steve Winwood and Peter Cetera and all them, but that You're Loved by the Outfield, oh, it's a really good song. It's classic. Don't know it?
No.
Yeah, you do. Cue it up.
No, I don't.
You're Love, Outfield. As soon as you hear it, and play it right from the beginning. Don't let me know when you have it cued. As soon as you hear the first note, you'll
Your Love.
Automatically.
Your love.
The Outfield.
Your Love.
Outfield.
Yeah. Is it playing?
Mm-hmm.
It's not there playing. It is. You have to push play.
It's good.
Yeah, it sounds great.
Wow.
I knew it. I knew I'd notice.
Oh, yeah, that's a good one.
I mean, come on. Oh. Did you miss it?
That is a good one.
I know. Did you miss it?
There's too? There's a lot of songs. I was looking at the titles going, I don't know that song. But if I listen to it,
I like my song. Girls a little bit older.
Gross. No.
Pretty good one.
No,
you're fine?
I'm fine.
Okay. No. All right. Well, fans, we've taken quite a journey today. If you'd like to support the show.
I don't know what just happened.
The roller coaster.
Take a second to hit that subscribe button if you haven't done so already. And share Totally 80s and 90s Recall with a friend so we can spread the fun and nostalgia far and wide. Also, you can reach out to the show on Twitter, X, whatever you want to call it. Subscribe to our Facebook page to interact, get updates about the show, or message us on Instagram or TikTok. We will answer anything you send. Even if you tell us to quit yapping. Yeah. We also have a YouTube channel. You can go over there and see some of my sweet dance moves. Although they say I probably got a zero on my breaking and popping, I think I got at least a 1.5. So that'll be okay.
Yeah. Is it nostalgia? Or is it nostalgia?
Oh. Is it Nostradamus?
It is close to the end.
I think
we gotta get
I think when said in the Queen's English, it's nostalgia.
That's so, what I said. That's okay, right. That's
yeah. Isn't it the King's English now?
Because spell out the. I think use the I and the A properly.
Okay.
The umlaut?
There's no umlaut on it.
All right.
Anyway, is that the little squiggly line or is squiggly? That the two dots?
I don't know.
I don't know.
It's like, I just like it's the
Like Husker-do or Husker-do.
Husker-do.
Yeah, anyway.
I gotcha.
Anyway. So rise, rebellious riffraff, it's time to rock. Getting ready to bust out your velvet choker and a baby tee. Feel like a widower and a former... Are you feeling like a widower and a former Major League Baseball player who was forced to retire due to a shoulder injury and wanting to move out of Brooklyn to find a better environment for your kid? You take a job in the upscale suburb of Fairfield, Connecticut as a live-in housekeeper for a divorced advertising executive, her young son, and her sexually progressive mother...
Oh, my goodness.
Man, if you're feeling like that, the Totally 80s and 90s Recall podcast is the buddy bossa nova to your Charles in charge. Visit Totally 80s 90s Recall at podbean.com, and we'll have you saying, I'll be back, quicker than you can deny ever owning the complete set of Ty Bo workout tapes. Thirsty for truth? Quench your thirst by sending us an email at 80s90srecall@gmail.com. Consider Dave and I your brain's personal pizza delivery service. We're not just delivering pizza. We're delivering joy, and we're bringing hot memories to your doorstep. Your cheesy nostalgia awaits. Nostalgia,
yes. I'm writing down that you got a Billy Blanks reference for Tybo into the show. You should be proud of that.
I am.
All right. Finally, you can drive the show's visibility by giving us a 5-star rating and a review on Apple or Spotify. If you really love the show, let us know. And not only will it help it grow, totally 80s and 90s recall to the level of popularity it deserves, you may hear your reviews on a future episode.
Yeah.
We may even let Kurt read it.
Mm. And God,
hopefully
no.
He will get all the words correct.
Not happening.
Right? No. It can happen.
No, it can't.
Don't doubt yourself.
And I never learned to read.
Cry, sweet freedom. Yeah, that's what
I want. I feel like I'm
going to have that in my head the rest of the day, and I'm not upset about it. It's great.
I'm glad I'm not driving home with you.
Rob, do you have any closing thoughts?
I really think we just got
2 weeks. That's 2 weeks in a row.
You haven't right even to the end
put here. Any effort in to closing thoughts. No, so, we do want to thank someone for stepping outside of their comfort zone and coming on this podcast with us today in a great journey. Discovering some wonderful 80s music.
What is happening?
It is the Movie Hound, Kurt. Thank you so much.
Oh, thank you.
You were a wonderful guest today.
Was I?
You were.
I tried.
Yeah, I mean, you're always a wonderful guest, but you felt a little extra wonderful today.
I don't know how I felt. I try not to feel myself
you did when I'm good. In here. I mean, somebody should, right? So, if not you, who?
What is happening?
That's right. So,
I just want to go home.
All right. That's going to close the doors officially on our musical draft room. We hope you've enjoyed our look back at some of the best music of 1986. If you like today's musical choices, we provided links to Spotify, Apple, and the Amazon playlist in the show notes. It is the Amazon playlist. So you can enjoy the nostalgia of all these tracks in full. Finally, we'd like to thank all of our listeners, whether first timers or subscribers, for hanging out with Rob, Kurt, and I. Hopefully, we were able to give you an hour or so of some laughs, great memories, and don't forget, nostalgia. And tune in to us every Tuesday for Totally 80s and 90s Recall.
Every Tuesday.
Every Tuesday.
Wow. I don't even know what to say. Yeah. What are we doing next time?
Ooh, exciting. Guess what? Kurt is involved again.
She's so excited.
I'm coming back.
He's back. You might as well just come every time.
And it's more music. More music. Yeah. Prior to the next show, we are attending a Foo Fighters concert.
The three of us
set loose.
We're going to be a couple of foos.
Oh, well, we'll be a few. Few is three.
A few foos.
Not a couple. You two aren't wandering off without me.
Oh, we could. Will.
I wonder if he'll sing some Michael McDonald. He likes to do covers. Maybe we'll get a cover of Michael McDonald from Dave Grohl.
I know they have the...
Or he'll invite you up to do one.
Yeah, I got you. Oh, how great would that be?
Wow. Hit it. Something just hit the bottom of the table, I think. Wow.
All right.
Swing.
That is the... No, swing. Okay. But yes, we are going to be, after that concert, our next episode, we're going to rank our favorite Foo Fighters song. We're going to talk about the concert. We're going to hope Rob keeps his shirt on and have a great time. What do you think, Rob?
My shirt doesn't come off. I don't even get in the pool without my shirt. All
right. We're going to paint foo on our bellies.
Big foo.
Yeah.
O-O-O.
I get to be the F.
Ooh.
You two are the O's.
That's okay.
Yeah. We got to stay in order then. We got to be spelled right. Otherwise, say oof or something stupid. Ofo.
It won't make any sense. There's only like a couple options. We can't mess it up. We can try.
You'd be surprised. So, all right. Well, Rob, you got anything else?
I can't do it. Nope. I got nothing.
What about a fancy goodbye?
I got no fancy goodbye.
All right. No fancy goodbye.
Yeah, Michael McDonald.
That's a weird one, huh?
Oh, you are Steve Winwood.
I did not. This is
something.
It's what did you put?
You put Casey. He's just it pushing says, buttons over there.
It says Casey and the Sunshine Band. I was trying to give him a tribute on the way out.
Wow.
Here it is.
There it is.
Casey.
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 Thanks for joining us, Casey.
Ain't you having me?
Can I have some black tea, miss?
Wow, what the heck was that?
Made me tea.
Mm.